Hello, welcome. In today's video, we're updating the list of the best Android emulators, with a special focus on 3D games. We only tested one system with 2D games, the Super Nintendo, so if you're looking for an updated list of the best Android emulators, stay with us until the end of the video. Before showing our list, it's worth mentioning that, except for the Vita 3K, all video captures were made directly on Android using a capture card, with no interference from recording software. The device specs are in the video description. We also used an external cooler to keep the temperature low, especially for more demanding systems like the Switch. The cooler's link is in the description if you're interested. If you enjoy this kind of content, leave a like to help with visibility, and share it in other Android communities. If it's your first time here, subscribe to the channel to receive future updates. Let's start with the oldest console on our list, the Super Nintendo, which has aged very well. Its games are still highly playable and don't feel outdated for most people. For this, we have SNES 9XEX Plus, a Super Nintendo emulator for Android that stands out for its ease of use. You don't need additional files, like BIOS, to start playing, which makes things a lot easier. Besides that, it allows you to customize controls according to your preferences, whether using a physical controller or on-screen controls, which makes the experience comfortable. Even on simpler phones, SNES 9XEX Plus works flawlessly, making it an excellent option to relive the Super Nintendo classics. In short, it's an easy and effective choice, even on older Android devices. Now, let's talk about something more challenging, Sega Saturn emulation, which can be complicated on PCs but is made easier on Android by Yaba Sanshiro 2. This emulator is very intuitive, both in its free version, available on the Play Store, and in the paid version, which brings enhancements. The Sega Saturn library is made up of around 1,027 games, many of which were only released in Japan. The Saturn was known as the perfect machine for 2D fighting game ports from the 90s. Just as DuckStation does with the PlayStation 1, Yaba Sanshiro can fix issues with broken polygons, a common limitation of the Sega Saturn and 3D games. It also improves the game's resolution without making them look like piles of triangles, offering a visually pleasing experience even today. And the best part, no BIOS is required. For Saturn's 2D game fans, there are filters that improve textures, making the gameplay even more enjoyable. The free version of the emulator offers many features, but if you want to run your games directly from a USB stick or SD card, you'll need to purchase the premium version. For true Sega Saturn fans, the paid version might be worth it. DuckStation is a PlayStation emulator for Android that stands out due to its vast library of 7,918 games, each with unique graphics. Unlike EPSA, it offers individual settings for each game, eliminating the need to reconfigure every time you switch titles. Although it requires additional files to run, DuckStation delivers a superior experience compared to the original console, with enhanced graphics and much higher resolution, whether in 2D or 3D games. Additionally, it offers special features like exclusive graphical improvements and fixes for 3D games that eliminate issues with broken polygons during gameplay. For those who are more demanding, it's also possible to install texture packs that upgrade the look of the games, offering a more modern and less blurry experience. It's an excellent choice for PlayStation fans looking for enhanced visual quality. For the Dreamcast, Sega's last console, with a library of 626 games, many still seek to emulate it to relive good memories. There are two great projects for this console, ReDream and FlyCast. If you have a more modest device, ReDream, in its free version, allows you to play only in low resolution. However, if you're looking for a higher quality experience without spending anything, FlyCast is the best choice. It offers all its features for free, including multiple save state slots, resolution enhancement for both 2D and 3D games, as well as compatibility with two graphic APIs, ensuring greater adaptation to your device. And the best part, no additional files are needed. With FlyCast, your Android becomes an even better machine than the original Dreamcast. When talking about the PlayStation 2, with its impressive library of 3,874 games, the recommendation right now is NetherSX2. While many are familiar with AetherSX2, NetherSX2 is an improved version after AetherSX2 was discontinued. This new project offers the same features as the original, along with a vast library of external controls, allowing the emulator to automatically detect and configure your controller without manual adjustments. Even without frequent updates, NetherSX2 is still under development, with a major update coming soon that will bring all the improvements from PCSX2 2.0. The only downside is the need for BIOS files, which can be tricky for beginners to find, but the emulator itself provides many hours of fun. Regarding handheld consoles, for the Nintendo DS, the emulator that dominates Android is Drastic. Running even on devices with only 1 GB of RAM, Drastic stands out as the best option. Previously a paid app, its developer announced that it will soon be removed from the Play Store, so it's highly recommended to download it while it's still available, even if you don't plan to use it right away. With a library of over 2,000 games, including famous franchises like Pokemon and Mario, Drastic offers graphical improvements, both in 2D game textures and with upscaling for 3D games. Without a doubt, Drastic is the emulator that's missing even for PCs, where DS emulation options are limited. And the best part, just load your games and start playing, no BIOS or additional files needed. Now, speaking of one of the most popular handhelds, the Nintendo 3DS, it is currently well represented by Lime 3DS. This emulator has struck a great balance between performance and accuracy, making it the definitive successor to Citra after its end. With a library of 1,349 games, Lime 3DS offers a high-quality gaming experience but requires a mid-range, not too old phone. The best thing is that it doesn't require additional files, allowing you to start playing right after installation. Additionally, it allows you to customize the layout of the 3DS's two screens in a way that suits the player best. With monthly updates, Lime 3DS is constantly improving, increasing compatibility with different devices. For Sony's handheld, the PSP, we have the excellent PPSSPP. This emulator is so efficient that it's already in an advanced stage, receiving few updates since almost all games run perfectly. With a library of approximately 800 games, PPSSPP doesn't require external BIOS to function, just add the games and start the fun. Moreover, it's compatible with most controllers, which are automatically configured. The PSP boasts a collection of great titles, like exclusive versions of God of War, Metal Gear Solid, and Ace Combat, so you'll certainly find something worth exploring. For the Nintendo GameCube and Wii, Dolphin is the main option. On PC, Dolphin runs on devices up to 10 years old, but on Android, it still requires a higher level of optimization, especially for those using less powerful devices. For beginners, configuring the controls can be a bit tricky, especially for Wii games that use motion controls. However, Dolphin offers two complete game libraries, without the need for external BIOS, allowing you to explore Nintendo's top titles like Mario Kart, Donkey Kong, among others. Cemu, the Wii U emulator, is a project that has been improving with each update, but it's still in an experimental phase. With a library of only 109 games, most developed by Nintendo, the Wii U was a commercial failure, largely due to its confusing initial presentation. While the emulator has some issues, it's possible to run successful games from start to finish on a powerful device. However, performance may vary, and keys are required for some titles, while others work without them. Keep an eye on this project if you're watching this video a few months after its release. Another emulator in development is Vita 3K, aimed at the PlayStation Vita. With a library of 2,198 games, Vita 3K attempts to emulate this promising Sony handheld, which was quickly abandoned by the company. Although the console was successful in Japan, with excellent games and some major exclusives, the emulator is still quite limited, with many issues, especially on newer devices. To run it, the PS Vita firmware, available on Sony's website, is required. If Vita 3K receives updates in the future, it has the potential to become a solid emulator, offering support for a wide range of genres and titles. Finally, let's talk about the most current console on this list, the Nintendo Switch, with two distinct projects, Sudachi and Yuzui. As of the creation of this script, in October 2024, there are already over 4,500 games available in this rich library. Switch emulation on Android is evolving, and many games can already be played from start to finish. However, you'll need a device released at least 2 years ago and with a minimum of 8 GB of RAM for an acceptable experience. Both emulators are derived from Yuzu and require key files to work. Additionally, some games, like Mario Kart 8, may require additional firmware. First, let's talk about Sudachi. Although this emulator is scheduled to be discontinued soon, it is still recommended for the number of games it can already run. Sudachi is a modified version of Yuzu NC, with slightly better compatibility in some specific games. Currently, it's the most accurate emulator, although it offers fewer options for those with more modest devices. If the game you want to run has moderate hardware demands or if you own a powerful device, Sudachi is a good choice. On the other hand, we have Yuzui, which uses a benchmark trick to unlock almost all of the device's potential without needing root access, allowing superior performance in some cases. There are versions of Yuzi without this trick, but the performance may be slightly lower. It is the only Switch emulator in continuous development for Android and has been receiving frequent updates, with the promise of support for firmware 19. Yuzi is recommended for less powerful devices as it allows you to significantly reduce the resolution, making it ideal for those with 8 GB of RAM or less. The emulator also performs automatic RAM management, and for those facing performance issues with Sudachi, Yuzi can provide a 10% to 20% FPS boost, though it heats the device more. The download links for all the emulators mentioned will be in the first link of the description, on our Patreon, available for free. That was our video for today, thanks for watching, and see you next time!